Hey folks, Armin Hammer here, and today I wanted to give a little bit of clarity on how the CrossFit Games is going to backfill spots for people who earn multiple spots at the CrossFit Games. Now, the CrossFit Games rulebook was just released, and honestly, it's pretty confusing about how this all is going to work, but I've spent a couple days talking to people at HQ and getting a little bit of clarity, so I want to pass that clarity along. Are you guys ready for some calculus when it comes to figuring out who's who and where they're going and who's getting the invites? All right, let's do it. The thing is, the rulebook makes it seem like there's possibilities for sanctionals to not be represented at the games. And I think the simplest way to describe the backfilling process is to say that every sanctional must be represented at the games. So CrossFit HQ will invite someone from the sanctionals no matter what. It just may be like down the line, even sixth or seventh place, depending on the other qualification processes. And you heard me say HQ will invite someone from the sanctionals, and that's a very important distinction that needs to be made. In order to qualify for the CrossFit Games, you need to do that through official CrossFit Games events, the open or the age group online qualifiers for the age groups. This doesn't really have to do with them right now, so we're gonna look at the open. The only way to qualify for the CrossFit Games is to be a national champion or take top 20 worldwide in the open. The sanctional spots are invited by CrossFit HQ, which means that the sanctionals are entirely separate entities that have no actual official place in the CrossFit Games. And that is a weird legal distinction that is both present in the rulebook and has been noted to me via email multiple times. So I guess I'm just gonna pass that information along. Invites, those are people who are coming out of the sanctionals and the at-large invites, I guess. And qualified athletes are people coming out of the open, for whatever that's worth. So now that that is clear, hopefully, let's take a look at what the actual backfilling process looks like. And I've made a very handy, very clear chart in order to lay out all the possibilities of making it to the CrossFit Games and what happens if those situations arise. Let's take a look. All right, so here's my handy cheat sheet for backfilling. Wait, nope, that's not it. Let's see here. Here we go. So here's how you can qualify for the CrossFit Games and combinations therein. If you are a national champion, you qualify. If you're a top 20 in the open, you qualify. If you win a sanctional, you're invited. Very important distinction, I guess. If you're a national champion and a sanctional winner, qualification, and a backfill from the sanctional you won. If you're a national champion and top 20 in the open, that's a qualification, that's a backfill, but it's from the open top worldwide leaderboard. If you're top 20 in the open, the worldwide, and you win a sanctional, that's a qualification, that's a backfill, and it's from the sanctional that you won. If you are all three, a national champion, top 20 in the world, and a sanctional, congratulations, Matt Fraser and Tia Claire Toomey. Really proud of you guys. Qualification, and it's a backfill, but it's from the sanctional that you win. If you win multiple sanctionals, that's an invite, that's a backfill, and it gets backfilled from the subsequent sanctional. So you get to keep the invite from the first sanctional that you win, but HQ will invite the next person up at each of the following sanctionals that you win. See? Makes total sense. And if the next person up at the sanctional, by the way, has another spot, if they match any of these other competitions or qualities or methods of qualification or invitation, HQ will continue down the line, which means for some events, it's possible that 4th, 5th, 6th, or even 7th place is going to be invited to the CrossFit Games. And that is a big deal. Hope that made sense. So there you go. The backfill rule does make sense, but you have to keep two things in mind. First is the rulebook is designed around the 2020 CrossFit Games season and on, which is when the open is what starts the CrossFit Games season. So when the open precedes all of the sanctionals, these rules make a lot more sense. Secondarily, it also helps to keep in mind that no one person can occupy more than one earned CrossFit Games spot. So you can't just suck up a lot of CrossFit Games spots by winning multiple sanctionals and being top 20 in the worldwide and winning your national champion. You can't just delete spots from the CrossFit Games, which honestly would have been pretty cool to see. I think that would have been a very strange but exciting way to just watch someone like Matt Fraser or Tia Claire Toomey just wipe off their biggest competitors by winning a bunch of spots. But either way, that is not gonna happen. Think of it in terms of the 2020 game season. Open happens first, you get to see the national champions in the top 20 worldwide, then all the sanctionals take place, and when there are situations where there are multiple qualifying processes, the CrossFit Games rulebook actually accounts for every single one of those. It's just laid out in a really confusing way. Hopefully, this video has made it a little more clear about exactly how the backfilling process is going to work. Remember, folks, there's a whole lot going on in our space, and it's easy to miss some of the most interesting and important details, like how are backfilling spots going to work for the five people that this applies to. With that in mind, that is what I am here for. I will see you guys next time, but before we go, I just wanted to say thank you so much to everybody for watching this. I really love being able to do this, sharing this information. Hopefully you guys find it as informative and entertaining as I hope you do. And honestly, if you do enjoy this, please like it, share it, subscribe, tell your friends about it. It's really important to me. The bigger our group is, the bigger our team is, the bigger our community is, the easier it is for me to provide this information, and I love doing this. I want to keep being able to do this, and I can't do it without your support. So thank you so much for that support and ongoing in the future, and I can't wait until the next one. See you guys then.